So you want to learn more about that camera provider for the camera view and select different cameras. And there was one very important thing that I forgot about the camera view in .NET MAUI. Let's check out in this video. In a previous video, I've talked about the camera view and how to get started with that. And I briefly touched on like, hey, how do you select a different camera? If you want to select the front or the rear, or in the case of like a desktop app, maybe some other external webcam that you got going on. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do just that. Also, I forgot one very important thing in the initial camera view video. So I'm going to talk about that as well, which is like preventing memory leaks and all that kind of stuff. So very, very important. Make sure that you catch all of this video. Let's just dive into Visual Studio straight away and let me show you. You know the drill, Visual Studio 2022. I did not create a new MAUI project this time, but I started from the previous video. So if you haven't watched that yet, I highly recommend that you do so that you know what is going on here. I implemented a little camera view right here, a smile so that you actually can capture an image, a flash and a zoom, right? So a couple of things, a couple of basic functionalities right here that you can actually do. So let me just deploy it really quickly. I'm mirroring my screen here to a physical Android device that I got right here, and the application will come up and you can see that we can just take a picture. It will show that in the image control that we got here on the top, and we can play a little with like the flash and the zoom, right? So that's how far we got with the previous video. So I'll just show you, here you go, the camera, smile, right? So you can take a picture, it will show up here in the top instead of like the little race car, and we got all of that. Okay, so that was what like in a really, really, really quick overview what we've built last time. And then I mentioned like, hey, if you want to do something with a different camera, because you can see now by default, it selects the rear, but other devices can do something different. If you're running on the emulator, it will automatically select kind of like the front camera. You want to select something different. Now, part of the camera package of .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, there is also the camera provider, which is automatically registered whenever you go into your MAUI program and you do the use MAUI Community Toolkit camera, that will automatically be registered for you in the dependency injection container. Super nice. And then that means we can dependency inject it here. So I can say I camera provider, we have that. And we probably want to use it in other places. So I also want to have this private field of I camera provider. I don't like the one, so I'm just gonna do this. Okay, so we have this one. And then we want to say this.cameraProvider is camera provider. So it predicted it for me. Perfect. What I'm doing now, I need to have this keyword because I'm referring to this one, else it's going to refer it to itself, right? So that's not really great. So we're referring the one that's coming in through constructor injection, dependency injection right here, to this instance that I've got declared right here. Okay, so camera provider, we got that. Now, what you want to do, there is a refresh cameras or refresh devices or something in here that is async. And doing async stuff in a constructor isn't really great. So what I want to do is I want to override on this page the on appearing. And you also have like on navigated too. Maybe that's even better. Let's do that. On navigated to. So whenever I navigate to this page, I can say, hey, I want to do camera provider dot refresh available cameras. And again, you need to do a cancellation token. So, but I'm not going to use that right now. Cancellation token dot none. So that I'm not going to cancel it anyway. I know that I'm just going to do this, and I need to await this, right? Because this is async. And then what I need to do is make this async as well. Now, you don't want to do async void. So make sure that you wrap it in a try catch or do some other best practices for async. You need to learn that elsewhere. I'm not going to go into that because that's a big topic on itself. But the least that you can do is wrap it in a try catch so the exceptions don't get swallowed here. But this is going to refresh the available cameras. And what we can do then after it's done that, I can say, hey, camera dot, oh, sorry, my camera. It was my camera dot selected camera. And this is a bindable property, so you can use it with MVVM if that's what you want. And you can say, hey, you can already see that it suggests to me camera provider available cameras first or default. So it's just going to take the first one, which is probably the default functionality. So that's not really super useful. But another way that you could do this is bind this available cameras collection to some kind of picker or something. And you can let the user pick the camera, or you can say, hey, swap between the back and the front. Or you can just select it yourself by doing something smart. You can say, hey, where C. So we're going to do this lambda expression right here, and we're going to put inside the camera, and we're going to say C where is flash supported, if you only want cameras where you can actually use a flash, or where you know the device ID for some reason, or you need a supported resolution for something, or a minimum zoom factor. Well, you get the idea, right? Or the position. So let's do something with the position. Is camera position dot, and let's do the rear this time. Well, no, the front this time. So you've seen it pop up with the rear. Now let's do the front. And then it's going to do first or default. It's going to select the first one. So let's just do that. I'm going to format this a little bit nicer. So now it should do select the camera, the front one. So like the me facing one. So don't be scared if you suddenly see my face bigger than in this little square right here. And we should see that one. So we can select the camera this way. Now, let's do that first, actually. So I'm going to run this again. And what we should see happening is that it's going to refresh the cameras. We won't see that. But then it will automatically set the selected camera to the front camera. The front camera. I keep confusing front and rear. And you should see kind of like my selfie face right here. So let's put on my duck face. Oh, it actually doesn't work. No parameters constructor defined for main page. Okay, this is good. So you see, I make mistakes too. And this is actually because, do you know why? Little pop quiz, do you know why? All right, very good. Yes, we need to also register now the main page in our dependency injection container. So let's do that. And we can easily do that by going to the MAUI program and say builder.services.add transient. You probably want to do transient for pages so you don't have any weird things going on. And we're going to say main page. Because by doing this, it can now automatically resolve the main page, and it can then automatically resolve this iCamera provider that is also registered in that dependency injection container. So whenever you want to resolve something, you need to make sure that the object that wants something resolved is also registered in that dependency injection container, or provide the dependency differently, right? But this is how to fix it for .NET MAUI. So let's try that again. It's going to deploy again. And now hopefully we should see that actually front camera pop up right here. So let me bring up the screen mirroring right here. See that it doesn't crash this time again. Here we have the little splash screen going on, and come on. There we go. Duck face. It selects the front camera. So I can now do the same thing, but now it's using the front camera, right? So you can do all these things. You can select the camera depending on what you want to do. Okay, perfect. Now, the other very important thing that I forgot to do in the previous video is you need to unhook kind of like the event and kind of like disconnect the camera handler just to make sure that the stream doesn't go on. You can actually stop the preview. I don't know if that's kind of like enough. We also have like the APIs I didn't show you in the previous video, mycamera.stop camera preview. So it stops the preview that you saw, or start the preview again, right? So whenever you want to do something, you can do start and stop and not show the live little feed right there to make it look nicer inside of your UI. But what we want to do is probably override here this onNavigated from, so that whenever we go to another page, onNavigated, or you know, if there's something else inside of the lifecycle of your application that makes more sense, definitely do it there. But for now, this is just like the onNavigated from. So we're going to go away from this. And what we then probably want to do is say, hey, my camera, my camera. And it also already suggests to me what I want to do. So it knows that this is something that I want to do. So media captured and minus is, so it's going to unhook that event so that there's no reference to it anymore. And it will clean up all the resources. You can see it gives me a green squiggly like, hey, watch out, something's not right here. It gives me a little warning about the nullability. So this event handler right here should have this object with a null right here. And you can see, Is it this one? Yes, no. Oh, sorry. It's the media captured one, of course. So it should be this one right underneath here. So that it has like this nullable object that's going on. And now the signature matches. So it knows for sure that it's going to unhook the right method right here. So we got that. And the other thing that you kind of like want to do just to be sure that it does not retain any references and it causes a memory leak, you could say my camera dot handler could be null. So let's make sure to not do that. And what we want to do here is say disconnect handler, so we're sure that everything get disconnected. You might also know this from the media element, where you have kind of like the same thing, so that all the resources get cleaned up whenever we navigate from this page and the camera view is cleaned up nicely. So these two things I just wanted to give to you so that you know as a pro how to work with the camera view right here. Short and sweet follow-up on the camera view. Now you know how to select a different camera. Did you see any other APIs that you want to learn about? Let me know down in the comments. And definitely don't forget to kind of like disconnect the handler, disconnect that event to prevent memory leaks inside of your application and keep the performance great in your .NET MAUI application. What did you say? You didn't hear about the media element yet? No worries, my friend. I've got videos for everything. Here is the video for the media element, and I expect to see you there in 1 minute.